This problem deals with the selectivity of parallel reactions, and it talks about a specific reaction of ethylene going to ethylene oxide versus combustion products. We'll just draw this as a very simplified scheme that we have some kind of reactant A, ethylene, that can be oxidized to produce the desired product D or undesired products U. All right, and these can be associated with a rate constant for the desired process versus the undesired process. And if we write down the rates for these two processes, they'll have some kind of concentration dependence. But what this problem focuses on is the effect of temperature, so running isothermally versus adiabatically, all right, which implies that we're going to want to do an energy balance and think about how temperature is going to be affecting this reaction. And so we'll want to focus on how the selectivity of the desired to the undesired product is affected by temperature. And we expect that the instantaneous selectivity is going to be proportional to Kd over Ku. We are told that the desired process has a lower activation energy of 15 kcals per mole compared to the undesired process, which has an activation energy of 20 kcals per mole. All right, and so that means that Ku increases with temperature more than Kd. And so therefore, we want to minimize temperature to increase the selectivity. All right, and so the question is, would we want to operate isothermally or adiabatically to minimize temperature? And so for an exothermic reaction, if we plot conversion versus temperature, all right, then as we go up to the conversion of 20% in this reactor, if it's an isothermal reaction, then we stay at constant temperature up to the final conversion. All right, starting from our inlet conditions. If we're dealing with an adiabatic system, then we're going to increase the temperature in that adiabatic reactor up to the final conditions. All right, and so we see that the temperature in the reactor is going to be higher under adiabatic conditions than under isothermal conditions, and therefore we expect that the selectivity will be lower for the adiabatic reactor and higher for the isothermal reactor. And so if selectivity is the main issue, then we would want to run isothermally in this case. The second part of the question asks which reactor type would require a larger amount of catalyst. Although the selectivity goes down, both rate constants actually increase with temperature. All right, and so we'll be increasing the rates of both reactions as we increase the temperature. And so therefore, we expect that the rate, because the rate is higher in the reactor, will need less catalyst to achieve our conversion of 15%. And so the adiabatic reactor, because it operates at higher temperature, will require less catalyst. And so that's the advantage of using an adiabatic reactor, is that the rate is going to be higher because we're operating at higher temperature. But the disadvantage is that the selectivity is going to be lower because the undesired process has a higher activation energy than the desired process.